Hi, I'm Matthew Price. I'm an interventional cardiologist. I've been practicing medicine since I graduated from medical school in 1997, and I've been at Scripps since 2003. I care for patients at several places: Scripps Clinic, Scripps Green Hospital at Torrey Pines, and the Prebys Cardiovascular Institute. So what does an interventional cardiologist do? Well, I specialize in procedures with catheters in the heart. So I do things like open up closed arteries using wires and balloons rather than open heart surgery. I also specialize in what is called structural heart disease. So people are born with problems of the heart, like holes in the heart, which need to be closed with catheters. I can use plugs and other devices to close holes that even 5-10 years ago, these patients would need open heart surgery. So what's unique about me? How am I different than other interventional cardiologists? Well, it's the combination of things that I bring to that procedure room. Number one is I'm highly trained in complex technical procedures. And the other is that I've led the field in breaking new ground, new medicines, new techniques, new procedures. So some examples of procedures that I do, things such as transcatheter mitral valve repair with a mitral clip, or occluding the left atrial appendage with something called a Watchman device to prevent strokes in patients with atrial fibrillation who don't want to take blood thinners, or closing very large holes in the heart, which may be somewhat tricky for individuals who don't have a lot of experience. And finally, there's putting in stents in blocked arteries. And although this is a common procedure all around the country, and in fact around the world, there are certain types of stent procedures that are more complicated. Patients with weak hearts, patients who may in some instances be referred to open heart surgery for bypass surgery because the stent procedure may be high risk or tricky. These are procedures that I specialize in, and I'm often involved very early in the development of these procedures where I test them and teach other doctors how to do them. So I want my patients to be satisfied, to understand what's happened to them and why we did it or why we're doing it. And I think that satisfaction and great care need to go together. And that's what I hope to achieve with my patients.